Rivers all over the globe has importance in human life. They are the source of fresh water, home of many aquatic plants and other species. In earlier days, rivers were main course of transportation, as the railway do nowadays. In India, rivers have a religious and spiritual value too. Many human activities are based on rivers and its adjoining places.
If we calculate all the rivers, either small or big, over the globe, the number comes more than 10,000. Why I am giving emphasis on 10,000 numbers? Because spelling a 5-digit number is easy, but distributing this number over the globe projects a very complex picture. And whenever a complex thing comes, the role of science-on-a-sphere also comes in. The science-on-a-sphere does complex scenarios in easy to understand and visualize format. Do you imagine how such big numbers of rivers are created? Who are the major rivers of the world? Where we stand in comparison? All this we are going to discuss here in an interesting way with the help of Science on a Sphere show. Good morning, I am Amitabh, curator of Sri Krishna Science Center, Patna. Today is World Rivers Day, and I welcome you all on the occasion of World Rivers Day. This is a SOS theater of Sri Krishna Science Center, Patna, and we have developed an interesting show here. What you see behind me, the present status of Earth, looks beautiful with its majestic blue color, as you see here. But around 400 crores year back, the Earth is assumed to be like this. If you see, I am draining out all the water from the surface of Earth. It looks somewhat like this. As you see here, the surface of Earth is very uneven. Some area is mountain or plateaus, some are flat, low-lying. All I can say, there is much difference in the elevation of the landforms. You see here how this unevenness created. 400 crores year back, when the Earth was in process of formation, the matter available were of different densities. Due to variable density, the heavy matter settles around the core, while the lighter matters on the surface. This process is called differentiation. So, two different level of landforms were made, but where the water comes from? The water comes from, the water comes through water cycle. What is a water cycle? When the surface of water gets evaporated due to heat of the sun, moves upward, condenses and forms clouds at different level of atmosphere, and finally precipitate on the surface. This rainwater accumulates on the surface of earth and flows somehow, which is known as run of water. This run of water, when takes substantial form and due to gravity flows down for a long period of time, it becomes river. So now look on the major river basins of the river. I am talking about 10,000 numbers. So here is, I am showing you the distribution of almost 10,000 rivers across the globe, as you see here. This is the India-Asia part, Europe, you are seeing. We are projecting here almost 246 major rivers here. Now have a look on the major basin across the world. As you see, there are more than 10,000 rivers here. In this discussion, we are selecting some of the major river basins of the world and some of our countries to show you the comparisons. What you see on the globe here is the river drainage basin of around 246 major rivers, out of which we are selecting some of them. So, what are river drainage basins? If I talk about this river, so what is the river drainage basin? It is an area drained by the river and its tributaries. This is the major river and these are the tributaries. This is the area drained by the river and tributaries. It includes surface water, rain water of the area flow in the nearby rivers. So, out of 246 major river basins of the world, we are selecting some of the rivers. And the first one is a river of South American continent. This is the river Amazon. On the basis of square kilometer or of the drainage area, this is the number one river of the world. It starts from the Andes river of the Andes mountains range and ends in the Atlantic Ocean. During the dry season from June to November, the width of Amazon River averages, width is during summer season is 9 kilometer, while in wet season it is 48 kilometers. So, my friends staying in the cities near River Ganga, you might have observed that in today's scenario, the River Ganga's width is around 3 to 4 kilometers since it is a rainy season in India, and the width the River Ganga approaches is maximum up to 5 kilometers, but this Amazon River is 48 kilometers width. It crosses almost 9 South American countries and it extends up to 6436 kilometer in length, which is still controversial. So, this is the total drainage area of the Amazon River, which is equal to the surface land mass or surface area of Australia. So, this is a biggest river basin of the world. The next river basin in the list is from African continent. It is the Congo River. This is the Congo River you are seeing. An inverted U-shape river, starts from Central African region from here and ends in the Gulf of Guinea. This is the Gulf of Guinea. It crosses the equator twice during its 4700 kilometer journey. Here is the equator and it crosses twice during its journey. It is often called the main road through the heart of Africa and it crosses 7 Central African countries. The third one in the list is also from African continent, and this is the Nile River. This is the Nile River, you see. It starts from Lake Victoria, somewhere here in Lake Victoria, and ends in the Mediterranean Ocean. This is the Mediterranean Ocean. The basin of Nile River covers 1/10 of the continent. This river basin area contains 1/10 of this whole continent. It crosses 11 North and Eastern African countries. This is the longest river of the earth, extends up to 6693 kilometer. This is the longest river you are seeing, is the Nile River. The fourth one in the list is Ob River. It is in of Europe, Ob River. I am trying to show you the Ob River. This is the Ob River, this one. So, one of the greatest river of Asia starts from the Siberian region, this one, and ends in the Kara Sea. This is the Kara Sea of the Arctic Circle. Its basin has more than 1900 rivers. You see the network of small and big rivers, 1900 rivers here, and it extends up to 5400 kilometers. So, with the Ob River, we have talked about four international rivers. Now, I am coming to some of the rivers of our country, that is India, and I am trying to show you the major river basins of India. So, first one is Indus River Basin. This one is the Indus River, and this, and here its basin is this one. Starting from Leh region, in Leh in Himalayan region, and ends in the Arabian Sea. This river crosses six states and union territories of India. It extends to 2900 kilometers. This river basin covers 10% of the country landmass. Please note, the Indus River flows through the Pakistan and Afghanistan region, and its tributaries are from India. So, this river basin has a major portion in Indian continent, India. The next river is Ganga. You see here, this one is the river Ganga. Starting from Himalayan region, this is the Himalayan region, and ends in the Bay of Bengal. It is the most sacred river of India. It has 17 major tributaries. This is the main area, basin area of the Ganga, and it has 17 major main tributaries. It crosses 11 states and union territories of India and extends up to 2500 kilometers in length. It covers this, its basin covers 26% of country landmass. And the third one in the list is the Godavari. This is the Godavari River. It is the second largest river basin after Ganga and covers 5% of total geographical area of the country, this river. The river starts from Sahyadri Range. This is the Sahyadri Range, and ends in the Bay of Bengal. It covers 8 states and union territories of India and extends up to 1450 kilometer. So, still so many datas. There, I think you might get confused here. So, in order to give you some more clear picture about these rivers, we have designed an activity where you can see the comparisons of these selected rivers on the basis of drainage system, drainage area, and the length. So, we will show you through an activity. It will give you a clear picture about the comparison of the rivers. We are doing an activity to show you how these rivers, selected rivers, seven of them, on the basis of their drainage area as well as in terms of their length. If we go for comparing all these seven rivers, how the comparison looks like, I am showing you with an activity. So, first it is with the area of drainage system in square kilometers. So, my first river is Amazon. Amazon is looks like this one, with a drainage area of 70 lakhs square kilometer. Then the second one is River Congo in African continent. It has a drainage area of 37,30,000 square kilometer. The third river is also from African subcontinent, and it is River Nile. How it looks in terms of square kilometer? So you are seeing the comparison of sizes on the basis of drainage area. So fourth one is Ob from Eurasia. So these four are the international rivers, the drainage system, the drainage area we are comparing, and try to show you how they looks. Now comparing these three rivers, four international rivers with three Indian rivers, how it looks. So our first Indian river was Indus River. It looks in terms of drainage area in a square kilometer, it is 11,65,000 square kilometers approx. And the second one is River Ganga and its tributaries. The drainage system is around 8,60,000 square kilometers you are getting. And the third river drainage area of River Godavari, the Dakshin Ganga of India, looks like this one. So these all seven rivers, on the basis of drainage area in square kilometers, look like this. So I hope ki you get some clear picture about their comparisons. Now I am doing the same comparisons on the basis of length in kilometers of all these seven rivers. We have studied, or we have seen in magazines and in our textbooks, how the length of river, what are the length of rivers and how they look. But while comparing these seven rivers, what will be the comparing picture is, so on the basis of length, the chronology changes. The first river is River Nile of African continent. It is around 6,693 kilometers. The second one is Amazon, which was first in the earlier case, is now is second in this case. In terms of length, it is 6,436 kilometers, 6,400 kilometers. Then we have Ob River, which was fourth in the earlier case, is third in length of, in terms of length, it is 5,400 kilometers around. And the fourth one is Congo, in again in African continent, is 4,700 kilometers. So these four international rivers in terms of length looks like this while comparing them. So now where stands the Indian river is the River Indus. River Indus is around 2,900 kilometers of length. Then the main river of India, that is Ganga. Ganga is around 2,500 kilometers. And the last one is the Godavari. Godavari is 1,450 kilometers. So with these two comparisons, I just want to give you another dimension of understanding. While comparing some of the international and national rivers, what will be the form, what will be the picture? Thank you very much. So friends, on the occasion of World Rivers Day, we have tried to give you some informations in a very simplified and an understanding way of the rivers across the world. And I hope through this SOS presentation and this activity, you might get some new ideas about the rivers of the world. For more discussions and information and addressing to your queries, you are most welcome to the SOS Theatre of Sri Krishna Science Center, Patna. Thank you.